Brian and I met, it was over a decade ago, and I think I had just put out a record on Nonesuch called Phantom Moon that he was a fan of. And so he asked me to write some music for Twelfth Night when he was directing Twelfth Night in, you know, Shakespeare in the Park. And I, of course, you know, leapt at the chance because it's, you know, not often that you get to work with a lyricist like Shakespeare. And that was a cool experience, but it was, you know, I had started working on Spring Awakening already at that point, but I had never actually had any of my music in a theater production before that time. So that was literally the first time, you know, any of my music for the stage had ever been made or heard by people. And, you know, frankly, I wasn't really that good at it at that point, you know. And so very kindly, you know, a decade later, he asked me to come write some music for Caucasian Chalk Circle. And I thought this would be an opportunity to kind of right the wrongs of my first situation in Central Park. Well, you know, I didn't, you know, I have to confess, I'm no Brecht scholar, so I had not read this play before, but I read it intently and enjoyed it very much, and you know, I have a kind of an affinity for certain types of music that come from that particular part of the world. There's one particular record that's called the Mystère des Voix Bulgares. It's like the, you know, women's Bulgarian choir, and I, you know, that record is like really kind of seminal for me, and so this gave me an opportunity to kind of play with some harmonies and tonalities that were very specific to that kind of region, and that's, you know, just creatively kind of exciting to me. A lot of the music that I make is, you know, I shouldn't say, I'm not complaining about the fact that it's contemporary, but a lot of it is relentlessly contemporary, and so it's nice to have the opportunity to kind of like be eccentric and be kind of, you know, go into my imagination about what that world of music might be, you know, and knowing, you know, a little bit about Kurt Weill and having, you know, kind of lived a little bit with that music and just having that be this kind of like spirit that's underlying kind of what I'm doing in whatever, you know, elusive, enigmatic way, that's kind of fun and interesting and a fun part of the creative process. Brian was talking about the fact that, you know, that in some ways the best way to do Brecht is to understand that a lot of his characters are clowns, you know, and so in our case, you know, you have Grusha and Simon who are maybe, you know, more kind of authentic in their behavior, but the rest of the people are, you know, you could say just incredibly over the top and silly and absurd, and I think that's the point. And so, you know, as I'm writing these songs and I'm realizing, you know, if they're sung in a certain way, there's like actually a lot of humor there. And that's a really nice surprise for me because it's not a place where I try to go to, but when things, if a song can become humorous, then I'm like really happy. It's often said that the reason why you have music in a piece of theater is because, you know, when the words are spoken, the emotion is, it's not, there's not enough emotion if the words are just spoken. It's only song that can kind of really make the emotion get to the place where it needs to be to tell the story. On some level, like, I just like to hear a good song in a show, you know, like if I'm seeing a show and somebody finds a really clever way of beginning to sing, and sings a really cool song with a really interesting lyric, I'm entertained or moved on some level. Having played, been, you know, just as a singer-songwriter and playing concerts and just going out and just playing music in front of people for 90 minutes or whatever, you know, that gets really boring too. So I love the fact that there's this back and forth between text and song and music and how those things kind of interact together.